Hi guys, I hope you're all doing well. So we've been hearing a lot about people's death, and as soon as we hear the word cancer, it is so scary to even listen about it or just read it, because we don't understand it well enough. And like, at least you and I, we do not have the, like, you know, why is it happening, what's going wrong, what's going on the inside, and why is every second person down with cancer and so many people are dying, like what is going so off. And so I just want to make this video to just enlighten you a little bit about the way I understand cancer, and just to give you the basics. And to be very honest, even with the kind of development and research work that we have at this point, we are still only looking at chemotherapy and radiations and everything, which is great and it is needed, but no one really talks about prevention. So if you look at Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, dementia, and all of these things, the clinical trials and research work is going on for the medicines that is going to help with the beta amyloid plaques that causes Alzheimer's, but no one talks about prevention of Alzheimer's, that you can actually, you know, get a blood test done, you can do your spinal tap test done, and that would show you, like, you know, if there is something known as beta 142 growing inside of you. And if they can see the plaque, we know that 20-30 years down the line you are going to be diagnosed with Alzheimer's. So there is so much that we can do possibly to prevent something, and this is why I think one of the finest quotes when it comes to health and medicine is, prevention is better than cure, especially when we do not have any cure. So just speaking about cancer, I just want to quickly tell you in a very layman term, so as to what is going on wrong inside the body. Now, we have normal cells, okay, and we have cancer cells. So what happens is, your normal cell, you eat food, it creates energy. Now, always remember, every cell in your body needs to create energy, otherwise there is going to be death. You need energy all throughout the day, all throughout the night, all throughout your lifetime. So when it comes to your regular cell, it can do it aerobically or anaerobically, that is without the oxygen. So in a regular normal place, you inhale oxygen, you let go of the carbon dioxide, and it's a great respiration process which allows the cells to produce energy, okay, using the mitochondria. Now, when we speak about cancer cell, so let's say the top two things that would fuel a cancer cell would be glucose, and there is something known as glutamine. Both of these things together can actually be a great fuel for the cancer cell when there is not enough oxygen. So always remember, the cancer cells do not need oxygen, okay? They don't need oxygen because they actually use the process of fermentation. So when we speak about your regular cells, they need respiration. That is why we are breathing all throughout the day, all throughout the night. It is controlled by the autonomic nervous system. But when we speak about a cancer cell, it does not need respiration. And there has to be the damage done to the respiration for the cancer cells to overgrow and, you know, create its own path of energy to feed the tumor, to feed itself. So it ferments. And when we speak about fermentation, there has to be no oxygen for the fermentation to take place. So in an ideal situation, it's done in the mitochondria, you get ATP, there is energy. But in a cancer cell, instead of mitochondria, the same process takes place inside the cytoplasm, and it leaves a byproduct. Now, that byproduct is known as lactic acid. This lactic acid can again travel to your liver, and liver will convert it into glucose. So now the cancer cell and the tumor, via angiogenesis, that is the formation of new blood vessels, has created a source of its own, has created an energy path of its own, and then it keeps on growing and growing and growing and growing, forming bigger tumors, and it can grow anywhere. So even if it is lymphoma, it's breast cancer, it's cancer in the ovaries, it's cancer in the prostate, the whole process and the basic foundation of all of these things remains the same. Now, the intelligence of human body here is, there is something known as cell apoptosis. That means whenever a cell is dysregulated, whenever there is some kind of dysregulation inside a cell, the cell is capable to kill itself to protect you. Okay, and it's a beautiful mechanism, and it takes place day in and day out, day in and day out. So why does the cell get dysregulated in the first place? So something as simple as smoking, radiation, virus, less sleeping, eating refined sugar, refined carbohydrates, all of these things can induce carcinogens. It can induce the formation of mutations. So every time you smoke and every puff that you take, it's not only damaging the soft lung tissue, it's not only putting nicks and cuts inside of the lung tissue. At the same time, it is also activating your body to repair the same thing. And anytime there is excess of cell division, because there is damage, there is insult to an organ, day in, day out, day in, day out, day in, day out, and the cell starts to divide very, very, very in a heightened manner. And that heightening can actually lead to mutation. It can lead to malignancy. And that is how you get tumors. It does not happen in one night. But one night is enough to put you in a situation like this. So it builds up. It's very accumulative in nature. It always builds up. So when you speak about cancer, this is what we know that is going at the source, at the basis. So, okay, leave everything. Leave glucose, leave sugar, leave fermentation. What we can do so the cell is not dysregulated. And that is why we speak so much about inflammation. We speak so much about stress. We speak so much about sleep, because it has direct impact on your immunity, on your NK cells. So people who are depressed, people who are stressed, so like clinically depression and clinical people who have stress, and people who don't sleep well. So let's say they are sleeping for 4 hours, 4.5 hours. It's enough to whack you out of just everything. It's enough to keep your body in a compromising situation. It's enough to dampen your immune system, okay? And when you look at sleep, so many people take it as a badge of honor. Oh, I sleep for 2 hours and I can still work all day, and I can still be up all night, and I can still party, and I can still go to the gym. Yeah, sure, you can do that. Talk to me 10 years later when you're not able to do anything. Because day in and day out, there is a damage going on inside the body. You're just too young, and that's why you don't see it. You are too occupied, and that is why you don't see it. But that does not mean that the damage is not being done. You should be grateful that your immunity is taking care of you. But there is a set point. There is a threshold. And when that goes off, you will always be in bed. You will always be in and out of hospitals. You will always be visiting like the best oncologist in the world, in the country. You will be flying countries, but it doesn't work. Look at the people around you. Look at the people who have died very recently. Do you think they did not have enough money? Do you think they did not have enough resources? Do you think they did not have enough money to buy organic food and eat it? But do you think that helped? Because once the disease walks in, and once there is disease, we are screwed, okay? And body heals, body forgives, body comes back. But also focus on what I said, prevention. Prevention is better than cure, especially when we do not have any cure. So suddenly trying to increase your immunity in one night and drinking turmeric tea, it's not going to help. You should have done this before it's too late. And that is why I speak about take care when you are young, you know. Take care when you are 18, 16, 15. Feed your child correctly. Don't let them know what these packaged foods and sugar and everything is. It's detrimental to your health. And this is why I used to speak so openly about a few brands that are doing such unethical work in the name of health. They promote a food product as healthy, but it's not healthy. And people don't read the labels enough. People don't know. So even if they do read the labels, they would read at the nutritional information. Look at the ingredients. Look at what they put inside of it. Even organic stuff, even vegan stuff. And all of these huge big brands, I'm not going to take names, but they are doing unethical work. Every single day that you consume that, it's killing you. It's not killing you, it's dampening your immune system. And then it can't protect you, and that is why you are killed. So just rushing after things just because it is promoted as healthy is not healthy. You don't find health in packets. You build health with every single meal that you eat, with every single spice that you put in your food, with the way you manage your stress, your relationships, your life. That's how you build immunity. Speaking about sleep, so every time you're not sleeping, of course, your NK cells are going down, which is dampening your immune system. Now, do you know that you need your immunity to put you to sleep? If your immune system is compromised, you can't sleep. So a sick person and a healthy person needs immunity. And here is how. So the cytokines, the chemical messengers that we spoke about in the last video, they can also mediate sleep. And when they are in excess, they will mediate more sleep. So in a healthy person, it is in balance and you get in a good night of sleep, which ideally is supposed to be 7 to 8 hours every single night, uninterrupted. And when we look about cytokines, so when you are sick, when you are unhealthy, what happens? Can you run? Can you take a walk? Can you jog? Can you move? Can you talk? Can you cook? No, your body is trying to put you to sleep because there is excess of cytokines. So in balance, you need it. But when it is not in balance, to see what happens, you will always want to be in bed because your immunity has been dampened. And how do you take care of that? By sleeping well, by eating well. So I am focusing on prevention. I am not really speaking about restoring, because once there is inflammation, okay, you eat a certain food, you had the sugar, you had the dessert, you are living your life, life is too short. Yeah, sure. But what about your immunity? The food leaves, the inflammation stays day in and day out. So when we check for inflammation inside the body, so when we look at C-reactive protein, it is only saying that there is inflammation. There is no way that we know where is the inflammation. It could be inflammation in the brain. It could be inflammation in the body, in any organ. And there is. If there is inflammation in the gut, be rest assured that inflammation is present inside the brain. And it is more than enough to give you all of these deadly diseases that we do not have a cure of. And even if we do, it's taxing financially, emotionally, for your family, for your body, for you. All the money in the world can't fix it. Okay? When we speak about sleep and stress, so always imagine your body has two systems. Okay, you have your sympathetic nervous system and you have your parasympathetic nervous system. Ideally, we want to be in the parasympathetic nervous system, that is your rest and digest mode. Most of us are always in the sympathetic nervous system mode, that is your fight or flight. Okay, you need it. You need it to regulate heart rate. You need it to regulate blood pressure. You need it to be able to let go of the digestive juices for the digestion to take place. So in quantity, of course we need it. But what happens when your epinephrine and non-epinephrine never goes down? It is always chronically elevated. Your cortisol is always chronically elevated. So now you are stressed. There is no sleep. You are stressed. You are stressed because you can't sleep. And it's a vicious cycle. It always keeps your sympathetic nervous system on alert. It's always high. And your body does not know how to deal with it. Your body can't physically, manually turn it off. And that dampens your immune system. And we have two immune systems. Both of them are dampened with the cortisol. So every time, every night that you spend binge watching something, one night, I think Dr. Lemon has said it really, really well. You just need one night to whack up your system. And sleep is one of the finest medicine to regulate the inflammation and just to, you know, flush out toxins from the body. But one night is enough to put you in a compromising situation. That is why we speak so much about prioritizing your sleep. Especially when we are in lockdown, we are in a situation to be able to do that. And I think all of us should make that our priority. Yes, you can visit doctors. Yes, you can visit dietitians. Yes, you can work out 4 hours in a day. Great. Good for you. But what about your immunity? What about recovery? What about stress? What about your emotions? Why is no one speaking about it? Why is no one speaking about preventing the cancer in the very first place? Yeah, we can all cure things and do everything, but it's taxing in a lot of ways. It is taxing. So we need to take care of it. Now, speaking about sleep, so I just wanted to quickly give you a few tips when it comes to sleeping. Number one, make it a priority, okay? The minute you know, when you're indecisive, oh, okay, I'll see, dekhenge kya hota hai, dekhenge kya karna hai, raat ko pata chalega kaise karna hai. No, it's non-negotiable. My sleep is my priority. So my sleep is not dependent on my life. My life is dependent on my sleep. So everything that happens in my life and my schedule is according to my sleep. It's the king of my life. It's the regulatory of my life. So I prioritize my sleep, and that is what I need you to do. Using phones before bed, scrolling through social media, and just getting in all of these, it hampers your circadian rhythm. It hampers your SCN. And your SCN is in sync with the rotation of Earth, the tidal waves. It is so sensitive. So every time you are sitting in front of a TV, in front of a phone, iPad, laptops, watching movies, and just doing all of the bullshit that you can do all throughout the day, it hampers and it is killing your basic system. It is killing the pineal gland. It no longer knows that it has to produce melatonin. It no longer knows kab subah kab raat hai, because you have confused it so much. So no, you can't use phones. Do not use phones, especially when you have a job or you're a student that allows you that privilege. I suggest leave it. And if you are someone who needs to use it like me, always wear your blue light blocking filters glasses, always. And it really, really works and it really helps. Now, if you have your dinner at 10 o'clock and you go to bed at 10:30, there is no way you are going to sleep. And even if you do, you're going to wake up feeling so acidic and bloated, because understand, digestion needs 75% of your energy. Okay, food is energy. Food is supposed to give you energy. So instead of putting you to rest, now you are awake all night because you just got energy. And that also confuses your body. It does not know what to do. It is time for it to rest and sleep and regulate and flush out the toxins. But you just gave it energy and now you are up and now you can't sleep and now it's morning and now it's one night gone and you are 1 inch closer to death and to disease because you're too occupied. Because you don't think it's important, because you think it's a joke, because you have a lot of money, so you can get to a lot of doctors and get things done. You can get a new organ as well. Sure, do it. Let me know how that works for you. So all of these things are really important. Just taking shower just before bed to feel fresh. You don't have to feel fresh before sleeping. You actually have to be a little lazy to be sleeping, you know? So you have to be just tired and worn out. And just imagine about a day when you're too exhausted. And just tell me about the kind of sleep you get when you're too exhausted. That's what you need. You need exhaustion sometimes to rest. And then you wake up feeling like amazing, energetic baby. You have all the energy in the world, irrespective of your age. Because your body healed while you were asleep. Because your body heals when you're asleep. It reduces inflammation. It reduces toxins. Everything we want to be careful about if we are so scared about cancer. So if you care even 0.1% about your own self and you respect this body enough, just take care of it. And you know, then there are two options. Oh, life is too short, so I might as well eat that and I might as well treat myself poorly. I don't know, I might die, you know, so I'm just going to die, so I might just do it. Or we have a second option. I should take care of it while I still have it. So this is what happened to me. I was yet to do my yoga. I heard about Rishi Kapoor's death and I read the word cancer. I read the word leukemia. And the first thing that comes to my mind and when I look at my body is, I'm so sorry that someone has to go through something like that. I am so sorry. My prayers and condolences. But I still have this. So many people do not have this, but I have this. I still have this intact. So I'm going to use it. So I literally had to push myself to do yoga because I was just feeling too off hearing about so many deaths. And it's just, I look at it from the view of health. And it's just like, why cancer? Like, what happened? So this is why I'm sitting down here, for you to know what I know. So maybe something inside you changes and you take care of it. Maybe 25 years later, because you watched this video and you took care of yourself, 30 years later down the line, your life would be better. Your life would be better than your peers or your friends who think that I sit here speaking bullshit and I speak here talking about just stress and sleep. Like, I don't know anything else to talk about. You're right, I don't. Because trust me, with everything that I read and work and study about and look at and the people that I follow, maybe I don't understand science. I don't understand biology. Okay, I don't understand nutrition. Okay, accept it. I do understand stress. I do understand emotions. I understand sleep. I feel it every single day, day in and day out. And you can feel that for yourself too. And it really, really works like magic. And it's real. It's real. Just because someone else does not agree with it, does not make what I am saying less credible. They just don't know well enough yet, and they will one day. I hope they never have to go through a disease to be able to know that, but they will. And we all have to come back to nature, because that is the only thing that heals, along with your body. So again, keeping your body in tune with the nature, it works. Prioritizing your sleep, it works. Taking care of your stress, it works. It 100% works in prevention, because once the disease is in, it's tough. It's very tough. irrespective of how many success that we see. Just, it is tough, okay? And I don't know how tough it is, but I'm sure it's really, really hard. So I don't ever wish that upon anyone, and I wish everyone who is going through that heals and has the immense power to go through it. But for everyone else, while we still have time, let's do something about it. Okay, take care.